celebrate the Lord's presence with us. We come to this celebration mindful of our need of God's grace, our need to hear his word to us in, through the words of the scriptures, and our need to encounter him in the breaking of bread. So, dear friends, as we begin our celebration on this day when we hold our annual meetings, let's offer this Eucharist for God's blessing, his continued blessing on the life of his church in this village parish. Remember our brothers and sisters in Christ of other congregations, of other traditions in this village. Pray that God will bless us as we move forward together with confidence into the future, looking forward to the opportunities and the challenges ahead of us in Christ. So as we contemplate the presence of the Lord with us in this celebration, as we prepare to meet him once more, let's open our hearts to his Spirit, that he might show up in us all that mars his image in us, as we confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbor, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in life eternal, through Jesus Christ. Almighty Father, who in your great mercy gladden the disciples with the sight of the risen Lord, give us such knowledge of his presence with us, that we may be strengthened and sustained by his risen life, and serve you continually in righteousness and truth. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Prepare ourselves to hear God's word to us in the scriptures.
The first reading is Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. While the 11 and their companions were talking about what they had heard, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? Why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I myself. Touch me and see. For a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day. And that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Let us now stand as we profess the faith of the Church. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true.
thanks for the many diverse social outreach services that are offered. We remember St. Mary's Church School, her governors, teachers, and pupils, and we pray for the continual guidance of the Holy Spirit working within that place. Lord, now, Father, we bring before you all those who are suffering in body, mind, or spirit. We bring before you the most vulnerable, the elderly, and the very young. And in particular need of healing, we pray today for Andrew Nair, Edward Fouche, Margaret Gregory, David Edwards, Fiona Caldwell, Peter Allison,
Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. But chiefly are we bound to praise you because you raised him gloriously from the dead. For he is the true Paschal Lamb who was offered for us, and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death, he has destroyed death. By his rising to life again, he has restored to us everlasting life. Therefore, with angels and archangels and all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. Same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this for me. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ has come again.
And so, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on Martin, our bishop, on Bishops Ruth and Will, his sufferers, and on all your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of our Blessed Lady, St. Richard of Chichester, St. Wilfrid, St. George, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. fellowship with all our brothers and sisters around the world, let us pray those words that Jesus gave us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass.
Son made himself known to his disciples in the breaking of bread. Open the eyes of our faith, that we may see him in all his redeeming work, who is alive and reigns now and forever. Amen. So we pray a prayer together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Sorry, we can't chat afterwards and get together, but